I've lifted weights my entire life. I started lifting weights when I was like 13, so it feels like forever. I don't see anything wrong with it, but I understand the stigma against, you know, girls getting bulky and strong, and I've had that feeling myself. I don't want to get too big, but I love the feeling of being able to go up and rip a bar off the floor and have guys, girls, whoever look around like, oh my God, did she seriously just do that with a side pony? I'm Katie Hogan. I'm a CrossFit Level 1 trainer, and I live in San Jose, California.
Well done.
Okay. I've got to admit, the worst question that any CrossFitter or CrossFit competitors we ask is, what do you do outside of CrossFit? Because the answer is nothing. We do nothing but CrossFit all the time. Ask anyone. But I can lie about it. And things that I used to do or what I hope to do in another life would be go to concerts regularly. I absolutely love listening to live music. It's my passion. I originally moved to LA to try to be a part of the music industry and work for a record label. I love it that much. And I still have this like pipe dream that one day I'll meet a rock star and be like, dude, you should come on tour and train me all the time. I'll be like, yeah, I totally should. Like, you need to do flips off of amps all the time, so why don't I just train? Okay. And then I'll be the first CrossFit rock star trainer. So coaching classes at Valley CrossFit has been such an amazing experience. And right from the get-go, when I started coaching, I was actually assisting Becca Voigt. And you know, her and I were already buddies. And so we found ways to make things fun wherever possible. Whether it was a silly game at the end or a really, you know, fun warm-up. Holidays, we would choose to dress up. Our very first holiday dress-up was a Halloween workout. And we both were witches, which was perfect because they just absolutely hated everything we put them through. And the dodgeball warm-up is something that she does a lot of times with her class. Every time we say dodgeball, everyone just goes nuts. They love it. There's never been like one person ever who said, I want to sit out and not do dodgeball. And we're like, all right, fine. You can just do the list of exercises. You know, training with Becca and Chris, we try to do it as much as possible, but it's been falling, you know, by the wayside here and there as we have different coaches, different programs to follow. So whenever possible, we want to do that. And if it's in the gym, that's great. But if there's chance to kind of get outside, you know, let's go do a hike in Runyon, or let's go to the beach, or let's go, you know, wherever we can think of to get outside of that. You know, Becca and I have gone to the batting cages before, and I know she's gone with Chris as well. Just kind of mixing it up and testing your fitness, if you will. You know, like a hike in Runyon Canyon, there's no part of that that you think you can't do, but it gets you out of the drudgery of the four walls of the gym and gets that, you know, that variety piece in. It might not be the hardest workout, you know, might not be the Fran level of workout, but it's still training, it's fun, and I like to do it with people that I love, so why not? I moved back to San Jose because I'm originally from here, grew up in San Jose, born here. My family's never left. My family's been here the whole time, so it was always coming back home for weekend visits or holidays. But it was really, I mean, it felt like I would get to see my parents like half a dozen times a year, which for me is not enough. I'm really close to my family. Both my brothers are up in San Jose now, or around the Bay Area at least. So all my extended family, everyone would always hound me like, when are you gonna move back? When are you gonna move back? And you know, that was just coming from a place of love. They wanted me back home, and I always knew that I'd eventually want to be back with my family, wherever they were. None of them were moving, so I had to come back to them. So it ended up just being the right time for me, needed a change, and it was a good move, good choice. I like to laugh, I like to smile. I cry a lot, despite liking all the joy and laughter. I'm surrounded by love every day, family, friends. I'm so lucky to have that. Whether I'm down in Southern California, and talking to my family and around my friends, or I'm up in Northern California with my family, talking to my friends down there, you know. I text Becca, you know, every day, and we just tell, you know, I miss you, I love you. Do you give me a workout to do? You know, what'd you do yesterday? What's going on in your life? And just being able to feel connected to so many different people, going on a level one and getting to meet people who tell me that they've seen video of me. Like, who am I? But they care. And my experience is now a part of their experience, and their experience they share with me. And getting to connect with a different group of 60 people every weekend has given me more as a person than as a coach. And getting to hear the feedback and people's struggle and people's journey and being a part of that in even a small way of just, you know, telling them to keep their elbows up on a front squat. They come to me at the end of the day and, you know, it means something to them that they were able to share that moment with me. And the fact that that's important to other people blows me away consistently. I don't know if I'll ever really understand what it is, but it's an amazing feeling and I love it.
There's so much going on, you're holding yourself at such a high standard, you're juggling 15 things, like, what scares the hell out of you?
Sharks.